Okay, so the Reddit user behind the Trump CNN body slam video is apologizing, and not just for the video. There was offensive content in this man's kind of whatever locker box of Reddit and his website. And this comes after CNN was able to identify the user, tried to contact him. So let's discuss the impact of this. We've got CNN politics reporter and editor at large, Chris Saliza, and CNN media analyst Bill Carter. So there are a lot of issues to unpack here, right? CNN is not identifying this man.
Right.
Why? Because in part he apologized.
Yes.
He said that this was a mistake. Not this video all by itself.
No.
What do we know about what this man was doing? And what do you make of the decision of CNN not to say anything?
And what he was doing was vile. I mean, an awful lot of this stuff was anti-Semitic, racist. He put up a chart of everybody at CNN that was Jewish. He was obviously not a prankster. People are defending it. Well, this was just a joke.
And they're saying it's a teen.
Yes,
it is
saying
not
a teenager.
A teen.
Right.
No, we can confirm it's not a teen.
It's not a kid. So, I mean, you can argue that CNN is actually protecting this guy, because if you revealed his name, what he did was really vile and nasty, and I think he would be subject to
ridicule. Should CNN protect his name?
I think that we're protecting his safety.
Yes.
That CNN is protecting his safety.
Yes.
Because
is that our job?
It's not our,
I think
it's
that
not
if
the
we
job,
can,
but I mean, the sequence is interesting. The sequence is interesting. He apologized supposedly before CNN, he contacts then CNN, but he probably had heard or sensed that he was about to be found out.
Yeah.
Interestingly, his apology, which he then posts, gets removed from Reddit. Why does it get removed from Reddit? Because they don't want this. They don't want people to apologize for this behavior. They want to be able to defend this kind of behavior.
I think that that's really notable, Bill, because, I mean, this is what I thought was remarkable, Chris, was that we saw somebody who was a troll apologize, you know? We wish that they wouldn't do it, obviously, to begin with.
Right.
The racist stuff is repugnant, obviously. But it went to the next level, where some humanity snuck in accidentally somehow. And here's what...
Maybe it wasn't accidental.
Snuck in, okay?
Yeah.
However it got there, all right? And so here's what he said. Let me read it. I would also like to apologize for the posts made that were racist, bigoted, and anti-Semitic. I am in no way this kind of person. I would never support any kind of violence or actions against others simply for what they believe in, nor would I carry out any violence against anyone based upon that or support anyone who did. One more thing, Chris, before I let you speak, because this is important. He talks about his own motivation. I was trolling and posting things to get a reaction on Reddit, and I never meant any of the hateful things I said in those posts. This is our world.
Yes.
People are doing this for sport and fun, and I think that when somebody apologizes, it's just a moment that we should note.
I think worth noting as well, though, there's a difference between apologizing and sort of being broadly forgiven for doing something that was not a one-off, as we've talked about before on the show today. This was not a one-off, Bill notes. I mean, he had done things like this in the past. I think it is a wider lens into a number of people who, and I take him at his word here, who do not understand, and some people do understand this, but who do not understand that doing things on the internet for and about people have real implications.
Yes.
That, you know, you can't just do this stuff and say, like, oh, I never knew it would hurt anyone. I mean, it's like going on television and attacking someone ad hominem and saying, oh, I didn't, why would anyone be offended by that? Do people watch television? I mean, you know, that's the... It doesn't take away from, yes, I think you make the right point, Allison, which is apologizing for this kind of content is better than not apologizing for this kind of content.
It's a little convenient when you're exposed and there's a lot of stuff on this person's site. You're not a bigot by accident.
Yeah.
But, you know, whatever. You want to be big-hearted about it, that's fine. And CNN's not exposing his identity. The president, though, winds up being the main story here, though, right? Because there are a lot of haters and hateful people and ugly people in our world, unfortunately. When you take what they are and use it as president of the United States. Yeah. Now the White House is saying they didn't get it from Reddit.
Right.
Well, then what does that
Chris,
mean?
Just very quickly on that. I do think it is notable that the White House has said nothing about where he got it, how he found it, but what they have said is he didn't get it from Reddit.
Right.
Well,
they're trying to distance themselves from this guy for this very reason, because he is a bigot and he did come across this way and he was anti-Semitic.
Well, should they have to say where they got it? Because I feel like what we're doing right now is they're not telling the truth. But let's leave it alone because we got more important things to talk about. I don't think you can ever surrender high ground on the truth. Because let me tell you something. The White House won't surrender it if they have it on the media, and they shouldn't.
But we don't know if they're telling the truth. We just know they're not being transparent.
But
we know they're not being transparent.
But don't they have to answer the question?
Sure. Well, they should.
Because if they didn't get it from Reddit, fine. Where'd you get it?
They don't. Clearly, they proved they don't have to do anything. They shut things down all the time when they don't want to talk. So they don't have to do it. It does sort of, it is a commentary on their approach.
Yeah, I would argue they do have to do it.
But who's going to force them, Chris? They're going to say
Chris,
no.
Well, Chris, they don't,
the media,
right. They don't
stay
have
on it.
To do it. They don't have to do it. Should they do it? Yes, of course they should do it.
And I'm taking it a different way, which is, I'm not talking about legally. I'm talking about the right thing to do for the American people. What are we dealing with right now? We're dealing with a crisis of confidence. We're dealing with the politicization of truth.
Right.
Only that is true if I agree with it already.
Yes.
That needs to stop. Everybody says it does, except most people are lying when they say that. They really don't want it to stop. It plays to their advantage. But I think they do have to address
this. In a world
of
principle,
if you didn't get it from Reddit, then you have to tell us where you got it.
Right. But in a world of principle, they do. But if you just throw that out the window, which they've done repeatedly on a number of topics, they prove they don't have to do it because they're not being forced to do it. Their base doesn't care for them to do it. In fact, they'd be upset in a way if they did it. It would look like a concession to the media.
That's right.
Which
well,
they don't want to
listen,
ever do.
Here's the guy who did it, okay, the Reddit guy who did it. Here's what he's saying that we haven't heard from the White House. This is just, again, a strikingly different tone. Now that it's all come out, here's what he's saying. The meme was created purely as satire. It was not meant to be a call to violence against CNN or any other news affiliation. I have the highest respect for the journalist community, and they put their lives on the line every day with the jobs that they do in reporting the news. I know you're laughing. He didn't have to say this.
No, he didn't. But to me, this is the reason they take it down. They don't want people saying
Reddit,
that.
Sure, that's different. Why is the Reddit moderator taking it down? I think that's gross.
Yeah, they don't want this.
But you don't think that it's out of convenience that this man is apologizing?
I don't care.
Well,
I think that the words are nice to hear, and
it would
be nice to have ever the White House say that they understand there are consequences to showing
violence. That's right. Words matter.
But saying fake news or
particularly
any ugly
when 33
things
million...
like that, this isn't just trolling is all I'm saying. And I think you got to be quick to forgive somebody who's coming forward out of convenience because they're worried about being exposed. Don't forget, there's a trade here. I'm going to be really apologetic.
Yeah.
Don't expose me.
I understand, but I'm
encouraged. Give him credit, but the statement is worth crediting.
Yes, the statement I think is worth crediting. And also, I just am encouraging this tone. I just want to encourage the tone. If you do something wrong, it's okay to apologize after doing something that was repugnant publicly.
I just don't think you're a bigot by mistake. That's all.
Yeah.
All right. On that note, Chris and I have talked a lot, so you guys didn't get a chance to. Thank you very much, Bill and Chris.